I'm Hiroshi Kawai from Soshin Incorporation. First of all, I'd like to thank organizer to invite me this excellent conference of Healthcare Expo Taiwan and to give me an opportunity to present this important session. In this session, I would like to give you all a topic as future trend of AI-driven drug discovery and development. At first, I will introduce our company and then overall technology, how to apply AI to drug discovery. And finally, give you an oncology program as an example. Let me introduce our company at first. Soshin is an AI-driven drug discovery company focused on first-in-class small molecule, including oncology and rare diseases. This company is originating from AIST, one of the biggest Japanese national institute. We are working with the vision of providing medicine to those who have no medicine. This is our management. Soshin was established in 2017 based on Professor Horimoto's AI proprietary technology. Management team include computer scientists as well as experienced people from pharma industry. Therefore, Soshin understands not only mathematics but also pharmaceuticals. This is an overview of our technology and services. Using multi-layered omics data, we capture gene signature and pathways caused by diseases or compounds. By these signature, gene signature pathways, we can extract reference compounds from our original database using our proprietary algorithm. Combined with AI analysis of pathways, reference compounds, in the literature, we provide services to our customers, such as identification of mode of action, pathway of compound or diseases, drug repurposing, drug stratification markers, pathway screening, and phenotypic network screening. Now, I will give you my view on current situation on pharmaceutical industry. Almost all pharma industries are facing tough times, such as decreased probability of success in creating a new chemical entity. By existing methods accompanied with increased R&D cost. And also society or government give great pressure to suppress drug prices. I'm not familiar with the situation in Taiwan, but I assure it is the same as this. At the same time, the growing use of healthcare big data is creating new opportunities for R&D to shift from target-driven to data-driven. Here, I will propose three technologies for transforming drug discovery. First, information and technologies such as big data, AI. Second is real-time monitoring. Third is new modalities such as regenerative medicine, gene therapy, gene editing. I will dig a little bit more about AI-driven drug discovery. This is a principle of drug discovery workflow. This fills the heat maps of gene expression. If you look at the left panel, gene set A shows the increased gene expression by disease X compared to control, whereas gene set B shows a decreased gene expression by disease X compared to control. In compound A treatment, the gene expression pattern is quite opposite to that in the disease X. Theoretically, compound A will show efficacy to disease X. If you look at the right panel, target compound is compound A. The gene expression pattern is here, and you can find the different compound, which is very similar to gene expression pattern of compound A. Theoretically, these different compounds will share efficacy to target compound A. This is the principle of the method that the Broad Institute presented before. Now we understand the theory. I'd like to explain how to define reverse pattern. The above is to define reverse pattern by distribution bias, which I explained in the previous page. Below, our scientists discover additional proprietary methods. This is to define reverse pattern by correlation. Look at here, target disease and compound clearly negatively correlated. Our system selects this compound. These are the pros and cons here. By distribution bias, computational time is short, but need more than 1,000 genes for search. And also, relative relationship is only -1:1. On the contrary, correlation, computational time is long. However, up to 20 genes for search is enough. And also, we can find out the absolute relationship. Now we can select therapeutic drug candidates by reverse pattern to diseases. We have two systems here based on the omics data, as I explained before. We call data-driven. The bottom use information of disease-related pathway here by selecting candidate drugs. We call knowledge-driven. This is an overview of our workflow for selecting candidate drugs. First, we decide target disease and gather information from open sources such as these. Then, the target disease information, such as omics data, is gathered from open sources such as Gale or from our collaborators. Then we select candidate drugs or reference drug by which I explained before. These reference drugs has a lot of information, so we use AI and whole information getting together. Of course, we need a confirmation study on efficacy on target disease and conduct several times this flow and find out potential therapeutic candidate drugs from this workflow. Here, I will show you an example of candidate drug discovery through the method I explained before. We tried to find out candidate drugs which could reverse cabazitaxel resistance. As you may know, cabazitaxel is quite efficacious anti-cancer drug for prostate cancer. But using cabazitaxel for prostate cancer patient leads to resistant to prostate cancer. So we try to find out the compound which can transform carboxylic resistant to carboxylic sensitive prostate cancer. So we measured and analyzed the transcriptome data of carboxylic sensitive cells and carboxylic resistant cells obtained from our collaborator, Kanazawa University School of Medicine. Through our workflow, we find out 30 potential compounds by gene signature obtained from transcriptome data. And one of them is named as SO001. I will explain the characteristic of SO001. To confirm the effectiveness, the gene signature was measured and shown in a heat map. The two lines here in the middle are the gene signature of carboxylic sensitive prostate cancer cells here. Up, down, up, down. The two lines in the bottom here are the gene signature of carboxylic resistant prostate cancer cells. You can see these two lines quite opposite expression pattern between sensitive and resistant. The two lines in the top here are the gene signature when 3 micromolar of SO001 is added to carboxylic resistant prostate cancer cells and incubated for 24 hours. SO001 here reversed the gene signature of carboxylic resistant prostate cancer cells to be similar to the gene signature of carboxylic sensitive prostate cancer cells. Now, has this lead to an improvement of carboxylic resistance? We have conducted in vitro cell survival test. If you look at the left figure, you can see SO001 has shown no effect on cell survival of both carboxylic sensitive and carboxylic resistant prostate cancer cells. If you look at the right figure, you can see dose response of carboxylic. 3 micromolar of SO001. These dotted lines are carboxylic sensitive cell lines. There's no effect on carboxylic efficacy. On the contrary, this actual line, black, shows carboxylic alone, red, carboxylic combined with SO001. So SO001 could improve carboxylic resistance. These effects are also confirmed in vivo xenograft model. Carboxylic or SO001 here has shown no effect on carboxylic resistant cancer cell growth. On the contrary, carboxylic combined with SO001 significantly reduced carboxylic resistant cancer cell growth here. In conclusion, selecting candidate drugs for targeted disease by gene signature or pathway can work in vivo and in vitro model. Today, I have just explained the example of selecting candidate drugs by AI-driven technology. As you may know, new information technologies such as self-driving vehicles are having a major impact on the existing automotive industry. AI can improve prediction of efficacy in earlier stage. Such technological progress will change the rule of society, in turn, which leads to change in the business model of the pharmaceutical industry. We should keep a close eye on advances in prediction technology through the use of big data analysis and AI technology to respond to change in drug discovery and medicine. Thank you very much for listening until the end of my presentation and wait for your kind feedback.